Who is that swab motherfucker behind the decks? It's Dimitri from Paris, and here are 10 things you didn't know about him. Number 1. He's not really from Paris. Yes, Dimitri from Paris is actually from Turkey. He moved to France as a child, and I guess when it came to choose his DJ name, Dimitri from Istanbul didn't sound quite as glamorous. Number 2, he's a huge fan of 50s and 60s cult cinema. We all know Dimitri loves records, but you probably don't know he's also a cult cinema buff. In fact, he likes 50s and 60s movies so much, he sampled Breakfast at Tiffany's, La Dolce Vita, and The Party on his debut album, Sacre Bleu. Number 3, he's a fashionista. Despite preferring the term stylish to fashionable, Dimitri is a big deal in the fashion world. He's worked on soundtracks for a bunch of major fashion houses, including Chanel, Jean-Paul Gaultier, and Yves Saint Laurent. Which brings us to number 4, he was a one-time catwalk model. When Yves Saint Laurent's creative director, Heidi Silman, was putting on his first Tokyo show, he convinced Dimitri to walk the catwalk. However, after watching the footage back, Dimitri decided he was more at ease in the DJ booth. Number 5, he got his first DJ gig by putting an ad in the paper. After advertising his DJ services in the classifieds, he got not one, but 2 phone calls back. Number 6, he was the first person to play house music on French radio. Before becoming a jet-setting DJ, Dimitri had a pirate radio show for 8 years, and he's widely credited with bringing house music to the French airwaves. It wasn't all quite as glamorous as it sounds though, as during the first few years, he broadcast his show from an attic. Number 7, his first remixes were made with only a tape recorder. That's right, one of the most accomplished remixers of our time started off by taping parts of songs off the radio onto cassettes. He'd then cut the tapes up and paste them together to make new tracks. It just goes to show that it's not the tools that count, it's what you do with them. Number 8, he has a long-standing relationship with our club. His first ever London gig was way back in 1997 when he played Valentine's Day as part of an all-French lineup at Ministry of Sound. In the next 2 decades, he'd be back countless times, so Cupid's arrow must have been on target. Number 9, he's a playboy, or at least he's a big fan of the brand. Dimitri was determined to throw a party at the Playboy Mansion, and when Hugh Hefner's people finally agreed, they suggested he could use it to promote his new album. The problem was he didn't have a new album, so he went away and made A Night at the Playboy Mansion. It must have been a blinding night, because 8 years later he released a second one. And finally, number 10, his first job was working in an office. For 6 months, Dimitri worked as a clerk in an office. It was his only non-musical job, but luckily he didn't stick it out. Paperwork's loss was dance music's gain, and we're all eternally grateful for that. This is Matt from Ministry of Sound, and that was 10 things you didn't know about Dimitri from Paris. Like and subscribe below, and don't forget to leave us a comment.